Okay, so now we'll discuss a feature that is EVN. What is EVN? EVN is the Easy Virtual Network. So what we do here basically, in this Easy Virtual Network, we use some VRF concept. So using the VRF concept, what we do, we get a separate line, end-to-end separate line. Okay, so I'll just show the diagram. Okay, I'll just configure the diagram here first. R1, R2, R3, R4, R5, and R6. So let's say we have these routers. They are connected like this. So this is customer one, customer one, another table, customer two, customer two. Now, another table. So right now what I want, these users want to exchange the routes that has a 10 subnet, that has a 10 subnet, 20 subnet, let's say. Here we have 10 subnet, here we have 21, here we have 10 subnet, and here we have 21 subnet, like this. Okay, so if I'll use a normal routing, so somehow, sometimes the packet will go to this way, sometimes the packet will go to this way, right? It means they will not be having a proper connectivity. And we're basically, okay, what we can do here, we can use this feature that is MPLS L3 VPN, but I don't have that kind of big network, okay? What I have, I just have this small network, okay, just these four or five routers, and I just want to exchange the routes with each other without using the BGP or without using the MPLS L3 VPN, right? I just want to use normal routing protocols and using some VRF, I want to do this communication. That's why this is called as Easy Virtual Network. Without BGP, without MPLS L3 VPN, I'll just try to make the communication possible using the same subnets in different VRF table. Okay, so what I will do, let's say I'll put this interface into the VRF A. I will put this interface into VRF B. Okay, I'll put this interface into VRF A. I will put this interface into VRF B. Now, how they will exchange the routes? Right now, we cannot use BGP, we cannot use import value, export values, right? RT values, we cannot use. Okay, so what I will do here, I'll configure this interface into two parts, two sub interfaces, dot one, dot two, dot one, dot two. Perfect. I'll put this interface into this VRF. I will put this interface into this VRF. We'll put this interface into this VRF, and same here, we'll put this interface into this VRF. And look here, now this will be a different network. I can use any protocol here. And now I can use any protocol here. So what we have here, a dedicated tunnel in between these two devices, in between these two devices. So in the normal network, in the small network, we can use like this, no need to use BGP, no need to use MPLS L3 VPN, like this, we can do the configuration. Okay, so we have the same diagram. So first of all, I will do the VRF part here. I will do the configuration for the VRF part. Okay, and I will configure the interface into VRF and the same interface I will configure here. Okay, now let's do the configuration. I'll start from R1. Interface F0x0. IP address 13001255000. No shutdown. Okay, on this another router on R2, I'll be using the same interfaces. Interface F1x0, IP address 13001255000. On the neighbor end, I'll be using 13003. Okay, now I will go to R3. I will open this router. I have to configure VRF first of all. IP VRF A, exit. IP VRF B, exit. Fine. Interface F0x0 is the part of IP VRF forwarding A. IP address, now I can put any address here. Okay, no shutdown. Interface F1x0, IP VRF forwarding B, IP address 13003255000, and say no shutdown. Now, these two interfaces are the part of different routing table. We can have same IP address. So if I'll check the interfaces directly, I can see the same addresses on both interfaces, but logically they are separated. Do show IP route VRF A. This is here and this is here. So here we have F1 by 0 and here we have F0 by 0, right? So this part is done, no worries. I'll jump to R4, 5 and 6. Interface F1 by 0, IP address, so that time I was using 13, I'll use here 23. Okay, 23003. Okay, so I will put here 1 and 2 like this. Okay, 1 255000, no shutdown. I will go to R5 and we'll be using same address. That was 23.1. Okay, interface F0 by 0, IP address 23001255000 and say no shutdown. No worries. I'll go to R4 now. So first task, I'll configure VRF, IP VRFA, IP VRFB. Okay. Interface F0 by 0, I'll put this interface into the VRFA. IP address 23002255000. I'll say no shutdown. Interface F 1 by 0, IP VRF forwarding B. Now I can put any address, so I'll put here same address, 000, no shutdown. Okay, now the real task. In between these two interfaces, we have to configure sub-interface and the encapsulation. Interface GIG 3x0.1, IP VRF forwarding A, encapsulation .1q VLAN, I'll put here, let's say 5. The same we have to use on the neighbor end. Exit. Okay, I have to put the IP address also .1. I'll put here IP address 34004255000. No shutdown. Exit. Interface GIG 3x0.2. IP VRF forwarding B. Encapsulation .1q6, IP address, same address I can use because now these interfaces are the part of different VRF. So I can do like this. I have to no shutdown the global interface, the physical interface, no shutdown. Okay. I'll just go to R3 now and have to use the same VRF and same encapsulation. Okay. R3. Interface GIG 3x0.1. I can use any sub interface, that doesn't matter. The encapsulation matters here. IP VRF forwarding A. IP encapsulation .1q. And that is 5. IP address. Address is 34003255000. Interface GIG 3x0.2. IP VRF forwarding B, encapsulation .1q6, IP address, the same address I'll be using here. All good. Okay, so till this point we have done. Now, what I will do, so this interface is the part of A, the sub interface is a part of A, sub interface is a part of A. So we have a separate tunnel now, so I can run any protocol. So I'll start from R1. So above here, I will use EIGRP and here I'll use OSPF. Router, even I can use EIGRP for this also. Let's use EIGRP everywhere. EIGRP 1 network 000, exit. R2 router EIGRP 1 network 000. Now here, router EIGRP 1, address family IPv4 VRF. VRFA. Autonomous number, okay, we have to define a different AS number on R2. Otherwise, we'll be having some issues. Router EIGRP2, network 000. Because the same process number I cannot use for different tables, that's why. Autonomous number 1, network 0, I can put here 00, no worries. Exit. Router EIGRP2, address family IPv4 VRFB. Autonomous number 2, I can put here network 000. No worries. The neighborship will be up definitely. I'll go to R4, router EIGRP, one, address assembly IP v4, VRF, A, autonomous number one, network I can put here 0000, router EIGRP 2, address assembly IP v4, VRF B, autonomous number 2, network I can put here 000, and finally I can go to 5 and 6, router EIGRP 1, network 000, router EIGRP 2, network 0000, and let me annotate the route here on R6. Interface loopback 0, IP address 6.6.6.6, 255.255.255.255. Okay, I'll rotate here. Interface loopback 0, IP address 6.6.6.6, 255.255.255.255. Now both R1 and R2 will receive the information. Do show IP route I'm getting, I should get. Just wait. Okay, so do show IP route VRF. A, we have that route. In the B, we have that route. Do show IP route VRF A. We don't have that route. Okay. The neighborship is not up. That's why. Do show IP, EIGRP interface. No usable router ID. Oh. I have to use a unique router ID. That is a mandate part. Router EIGRP 1 router ID. Address assembly IPv4 VRF A. Autonomous number 1. EIGRP router ID. So I'll put here, let's say 13.13.13.13. Exit, router EIGRP 2, address assembly IPv4 VRF B, autonomous number 2, router ID will put here. Okay, now I'll go to next router R4, the same issue here we have. Router EIGRP 1. Address assembly IPv4 VRF A, autonomous number 1. EIGRP router ID. So I'll put here 45.45.45.45. Router EIGRP 2. Address assembly IPv4 VRF B, autonomous number 2. EIGRP router ID. Let me put here 46.46.46.46. That is mandate part. Do show IP EIGRP neighbor. Show IP EIGRP neighbor for VRF. VRF A. Show IP EIGRP VRF A1. Interfaces. So yes, these are the interfaces that we have. Neighbors, only 23001. Cool. Let me just check the reachability. Ping VRF A34003. That is not reachable. So due to that reason, this is not up. Interface gig 3x0, no shutdown. Do show IP interface brief. Now that is up, the neighborship will be up, fine. Do show IP route. All good, I'm getting the information here. Do show IP route, I'm getting the route here. How we can verify that traffic is going to the same destination? Cool. Debug IP ICMP. Debug IP ICMP. Okay. So I'll just do a ping from R1. So now it should go to R5. So look here, R5 is giving me a reply, right? Not R6. If I do a ping from here, so R6 will give me a reply, not R5. Finally, R6 is giving me a reply. So this is how we can use EVPN, EVN, Easy Virtual Network. So we have a tunnel in between this small network. So this is the concept of EVN.